I was so excited sitting back there and listening to my favorite piece being played. Definitely like 100,000 times better than what I played.
而且真的是太精彩了，就像是 Betty 所说的，每一次我们听这首曲目，真的是经典的耐人寻味，每一次听都更加的动人，更加的感动。
是啊，刚刚听的时候，其实我自己就会感受得到老师们在慢轻急缓重的时候，你都可以感受到他们在之间传递的情绪是不一样的。我觉得这也是弦乐的一个非常大的特色，就是它能够传递一些非常细微的东西。那其他的一些乐器可能就做不到这一点。
I remember you learned how to play our whole since you were 9 years old, right? So based on your experience, personally speaking, in order to perform like professional like just now.How many years practice exactly it's going to take?
Let's just say that I've been playing for, I guess when I was taking classes, that was like about 6 years, and I was not confident after 6 years.
No confident
enough,
right?
It definitely takes many, many years of practicing afterwards, and it takes life experiences, because you have to feel the emotions. You can't just be using your techniques, you have to be actually playing your soul into it.
没错，而且呢，像你刚刚说的，这么多年的就是我们的practice 之后，我们还没有 confidence 在舞台上表演，而且呢，自己表演和一个团队表演又是完全不同的事情，大家又配合，又感受到音律的脉动，这都是非常专业的，所以我们的老师非常非常的不容易。那接下来呢，在我们进行我们的闽乐专场的最后一个演出之前呢，我要再次感谢我们的北美中乐团，我们非常非常的荣幸各位老师能够把这么专业的表演带到我们的 Toronto Dragon Festival the second year, 那真的是我们非常难得的一个经历。
We want to express our greatest appreciation for the North America Traditional Chinese Orchestra again for all their hard work and the amazing pieces they're bringing us today.Now that we've heard from a variety of instruments, it's time for the grand finale of our traditional Chinese instruments performances.
我们即将欣赏到的是中华管弦乐团合奏。哇，这个 title 大气了，是我们所有的非常著名的老师和学员一起联袂为大家表演我们乐团时间的压轴好戏。这是近代发展出的一种以中国民乐民族乐器为基础，在融合了西方交响乐团的编制而成立的独立的新颖的乐队类型。
The evolution of modern Chinese orchestras always reminds me of the quote that music has no boundaries. No matter what language, genre, rhythm, it can always find a way to everyone's heart.
俗话说，音乐无国界。感谢这些所有的热爱音乐和奉献音乐的音乐家们，将中华传统乐器和传统文化推向了世界的大舞台。下面，请欣赏大型民族管弦乐合奏。北京喜讯、道边寨和鸿雁，让我们一起欣赏。
那个是